Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Let the whole earth stand in awe of him.
O Lord, open thou our lips.
And the mouth shall show forth thy praise.
O God, make speed to save us. To the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Praise ye the Lord.
The Lord's name, the blessed name.
Psalms are those appointed for the 28th evening, 136, 137, and 138.
Oh,
The first lesson is written in the first book of Samuel, the 14th chapter, beginning at the first verse. This is the account of a foray made against the Philistines by Jonathan, the king's son, and his armor bearer. One day, Jonathan, the son of Saul, said to the young man who bore his armor, "Come, let us go over to the Philistine garrison on yonder side." But he did not tell his father. Saul was staying in the outskirts of Gibeah, under the pomegranate tree which is at Migron. The people who were with him were about 600 men. And Ahijah, the son of Ahitub, Ichabod's brother, son of Phinehas, son of Eli, the priest of the Lord in Shiloh, wearing an ephod. And the people did not know that Jonathan had gone. In the pass by which Jonathan sought to go over to the Philistine garrison, there was a rocky crag on the one side and a rocky crag on the other side. The name of the one was Bozez, and the name of the other Sene. The one crag rose on the north in front of Michmash, and the other on the south in front of Geba. And Jonathan said to the young man who bore his armor, "Come, let us go over to the garrison of these uncircumcised. It may be that the Lord will work for us. For nothing can hinder the Lord from saving, by many or by few." And his armor bearer said to him, "Do all that your mind inclines to. Behold, I am with you, as is your mind, so is mine." Then said Jonathan, "Behold, we will cross over to the men, and we will show ourselves to them. If they say to us, 'Wait until we come to you,' then we will stand still in our place, and we will not go to them. But if they say, 'Come up to us,' then we will go up, for the Lord has given them into our hand, and this shall be the sign to us." So both of them showed themselves to the garrison of the Philistines, and the Philistines said, "Look, Hebrews are coming out of the holes where they have hid themselves." And the men of the garrison hailed Jonathan and his armor bearer and said, "Come up to us, and we will show you a thing." And Jonathan said to his armor bearer, "Come up after me, for the Lord has given them into the hand of Israel." Then Jonathan climbed up on his hands and feet, and his armor bearer after him. And they fell before Jonathan, and his armor bearer killed them after him. And that first slaughter which Jonathan and his armor bearer made was of about 20 men, within, as it were, half a furrow's length in an acre of land. And there was a panic in the camp, in the field, and among all the people. The garrison and even the raiders trembled. The earth quaked, and it became a very great panic. Here endeth the first lesson.
Thank you. second lesson is written in the Epistle of St. Paul to the Galatians, chapter 4, beginning at verse 12. St. Paul pleads with the Christians in Galatia who have forsaken him for false teachers. Brethren, I beseech you, become as I am, for I also have become as you are. You did me no wrong. You know it was because of a bodily ailment that I preached the gospel to you at first. And though my condition was a trial to you, you did not scorn or despise me, but received me as an angel of God, as Christ Jesus. What has become of the satisfaction you then felt? For I bear you witness that if possible you would have plucked out your eyes and given them to me. Have I then become your enemy by telling you the truth? They make much of you, but for no good purpose. They want to shut you out, that you may make much of them. For a good purpose, it is always good to be made much of, and not only when I am present with you. My little children, with whom I am again in travail until Christ be formed in you, I could wish to be present with you now and to change my tone, for I am perplexed about you. Here ends the second lesson.
In God,
the Father Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth,
The Lord be with you.
And with my spirit.
Let us pray.
Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us.
Our Father, show thy mercy upon us.
And grant us thy salvation.
O Lord, save the Queen.
And mercifully hear us when we call on thee.
Endue thy ministers with righteousness. Seest that we put not our trust in anything that we do, mercifully grant that by thy power we may be defended against all adversity through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
O God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works do proceed, give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that both our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee we, being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness through the merits of Jesus Christ our Saviour. Lighten our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy, defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of thy only Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. The anthem is Exultate Deo, the music by Palestrina.
Thank you.
Let us pray for the Queen and all who are set in authority under her. Almighty God, the fountain of all goodness, we humbly beseech thee to bless our sovereign lady, Queen Elizabeth, the parliaments in all her dominions, and all who are set in authority under her, that they may order all things in wisdom, righteousness, and peace, to the honor of thy holy name and the good of thy church and people, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray for the church, and especially for the clergy and people of this Diocese of Birmingham. Almighty and everlasting God, who alone workest great marvels, send down upon our bishops and clergy and all congregations committed to their charge the healthful spirit of thy grace, and that they may truly please thee, pour upon them the continual dew of thy blessing. Grant this, O Lord, for the honor of our advocate and mediator, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Let us pray for the peace of the world. Almighty God, from whom all thoughts of truth and peace proceed, kindle, we pray thee, in the hearts of all men, the true love of peace, and guide with thy pure and peaceable wisdom those who take counsel for the nations of the earth, that in tranquility thy kingdom may go forward till the earth is filled with the knowledge of thy love. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Almighty God, who has given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications unto thee, and dost promise that when two or three are gathered together in thy name, thou wilt grant their requests, fulfill now, O Lord, the desires and petitions of thy servants as may be most expedient for them, granting us in this world knowledge of thy truth, and in the world to come, life everlasting.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Ghost be with us all evermore.
Amen.
Thank you. This week's Choral Evensong was broadcast from Birmingham Cathedral. The organist and master of the choristers was Roy Massey, and the sub-organist, John Pryer. And incidentally, the voluntary at the end of the service was the first movement of Mendelssohn's Sonata No. 3. Next Wednesday is Ash Wednesday, and Choral Evensong will come from St. John's College, Cambridge. On that occasion, the music will include the setting by Allegri of the 51st Psalm, Miserere Mei. That's next Wednesday, Choral Evensong at 4 o'clock.